The most revolutionary question in the world today is reparations to African people. We salute African People's Socialist Party Chairman Omali Ishatela and the scientific theory of African internationalism which informs this video. As Chairman Omali Ishatela explains,
slavery, genocide, theft, rape, and colonialism built parasitic capitalism, and the wealth and power of the US, Europe, and every white person on the planet.
Thus, we are only 11.5% of the world's nearly 8 billion people enjoying the highest mass standard of living ever experienced in the history of humankind. Our lives play out on the pedestal on the backs of African, indigenous, and colonized peoples who are rising up and fighting for their liberation no matter the price. Capitalism was born and got rich from assaulting Africa, kidnapping African people, enslaving them, creating a giant world economy around selling African human beings as commodities on land stolen from the indigenous people and drenched in their blood. This is why capitalism is by nature parasitic, requiring lethal armies and unending warfare, capturing every independent, proud, and self-determining people on the planet, trapping them in the deadly web of degradation called colonialism, neocolonialism, and dependency for our benefit. Chairman Omali Ishatela.
Capitalism was born in disrepute of the rapes, massacres, occupations, genocides, colonialism, and every despicable act humans are capable of inflicting. What capitalism did was to rip the vast majority of humans out of the productive process. In Africa, Asia, the Middle East, Australia, and what has come to be known as the Americas. The hundreds of millions dead due to the slave trade and slavery itself, the millions exterminated everywhere Europeans ventured. These are people whose hands were forever removed from a relationship with nature that would result in production. Europeans achieved their national identity by way of this bloody process. This is not something that only happened a long time ago. The world's peoples are suffering the consequence of capitalism's emergence right now.
So the configuration of an entire planet constructed for the gain, pleasure, enrichment, and intellectual advancement of a tiny minority of the population of the world at the expense of everybody else. A status we have never hesitated to murder and terrorize to maintain. Potential scientists whipped to death in the cotton fields. Teachers hang from trees in Georgia, doctors dead in childbirth somewhere on the south side of Chicago, artists hogtied in the woods of Alabama. It has been said that the very struggle for life on the plantation required absolute genius. The countless, nameless African people whose brilliance, even today, is expressed in the mere act of survival, a survival that depends on the ability to produce and reproduce life for the colonizer, as Chairman Omali Ishatela stated. The dreams and aspirations of centuries of African people were hijacked to feed our children, build our cities, pave our streets, create our futures, realize our dreams, giving us our generational wealth that puts a down payment on our first house and pays our student loans. Thus, the two Americas, the colonizer and the colonized, between us and African people, a wall of colonialism backed up by the razor wire of the police state. The income gap, the education gap, the jails, the police, the healthcare, the experience of democratic rights, the lives of the oppressors and the oppressed, one living at the expense of the other. At the root of every problem in the world today, police murders and white nationalist violence, growing poverty, the burning of the Amazon, the threat of nuclear war, the daily bombing of Palestine, US drone strikes in the Middle East, gender and women's oppression, trace it all back, and it all has the same root, parasitic capitalism, a filthy, blood-sucking social system with nothing but profit for a motive, slaughter and conquest that expects and gets our unity and complicity and ends that justify all means. At the root and foundation of capitalism is parasitism, slavery, genocide, and colonialism. Thus, reparations is the revolutionary demand. The foundation is rising up because this system must go. There is no reform or beautiful, visionary world that can be built on a foundation of rot, violence, rape, and pillage. The foundation must go. The entire system must go. The colonial state must go. The majority of humanity is demanding to be free, unleashing their leadership and genius for the benefit of the people, not profit and plunder. Reparations is a demand of the African revolution because
African people are going to be free.
African people are organized in a party fiercely led by the interests of the African working class, the African People's Socialist Party, which leads Uhuru Solidarity Movement too.
African people are going to wield power. We are serious about governing ourselves. We are fighting colonialism wherever we have been dispersed, fighting for one liberated Africa, the return of our people, resources, land, and value of our stolen labor.
Reparations. Africa's oil is African people's oil. Africa's coltan and diamonds belong to African people. Africa's land is theirs. The value of stolen African labor belongs to African workers. African revolution, bringing all oppressed people with them, uplifting everyone who wants to come, including you and me.
Therefore, the African revolution is the impetus for all revolution, the weakest link of imperialism embedded within its foundation, pedestal, and very borders, the cornerstone of parasitic capitalism.
The African People's Socialist Party has assigned us to actually pay reparations to African people, to the African Revolution, returning their stolen wealth. Through reparations, we make our self-criticism to African people and the colonized of the earth. Reparations is the true redistribution of the wealth of the world. Through reparations, we turn loose our whiteness, no longer upholding a system that feeds our desires through theft and violence. So we have work to do, a true revolutionary assignment that frees us from the despair that comes from being imperialist foot soldiers against the rest of the world. Within the belly of the capitalist beast, in our own communities, we are called on to win every white woman, man, and child to help seize the stolen wealth and return it to the African liberation movement as a revolutionary act, as a positive and optimistic stand that helps turn the world right side up, unites with the future of the liberated African nation, creating a world of peace, of justice, of universal prosperity, productivity, and power in the hands of colonized workers. A world without oppressors and oppressed, under the leadership of the African working class, in solidarity with all living beings, constructing a planet in which all people can live and thrive, no one at the expense of anybody else.